Winter Haven, we have plenty of clubs and sports. No matter what you're interested in, I guarantee you Winter Haven will have something for you. I'm Izzy with BDTV. Let's go take a look. This must be band. Here at our school, our band is called the Pride of Winter Haven. Maybe I should give it a shot. I better not. Pajamas? Oh wait, these are scrubs. So that must mean we're in the medical academy. Ugh. Yeah, I just don't think I'm cut out for this.
Hike!
Ugh. So I guess this is football. Our team works really hard on season and off season to be the best they can be. I just really don't think contact sports are for me. So maybe sports aren't for me, but it's not too late for me to be the next Picasso. This is our art room. Our students here are so talented that their art even goes on to be displayed in the art show. Yeah, I should Vincent Van Gogh.
Oh, I know where we are. This is Blue Devil Television, or more commonly known as BDTV. This is where our morning news show is produced and edited every single day. And more than just making the news show, we also compete in multiple competitions. This is where I fit in, and this is where my talents are best put to use. So just because one club doesn't work out, or multiple, doesn't mean you don't fit in anywhere. So don't give up, and find where you belong. Good morning, Winter Haven. I'm Izzy with BDTV.
Want anything?
That was hard to watch, right? So imagine what it's like to live a lifestyle like this. Unfortunately, this lifestyle is a reality for every 1 in 50 women. Especially as a teen, women are at a higher risk for developing body dysmorphia. But what about my guys watching? Guys too are also at a high risk for developing this disorder. And it doesn't help that social media portrays unrealistic body types that have been processed and edited to perfection. Society is constantly telling us what the ideal body looks like. But I'm here to tell you that your ideal body is the one that you already have. Your body works hard to fight off sickness, absorb nutrients, and give you the energy that you need. As much as your body works for you, you need to take care of yourself and appreciate it. The number on the scale and the size that you wear are not numbers that define you. I'm Izzy with BDTV, and you're perfect just the way you are.
In everyday life, we interact with our environment all the time. From the food we eat, to the water we drink, to the air we breathe, the Earth is what's keeping us alive. And because the Earth does so much for us, you think we'd give back to it, or at least protect it, but that's not the case. The Earth experiences various pollutants that are slowly killing the environment. I'm Izzy with BDTV, and today I'm here to give you a couple tips to help save the world. Tip number one, recycle, obviously. The first thing you're told to do when you hear about helping the environment is to reduce, reuse, and recycle. Yet 80% of the trash found in landfills is actually recyclable. So all you need to do to recycle is take any plastics, cardboards, glass, or tin and put it in the recycle bin, not the trash bin. The recycle man will take care of the rest.
But I know we can't always recycle because we still produce trash. But a good way to reduce the trash that you produce is to use reusable containers. Nowadays, there's a reusable container for everything. Simple Tupperware, salad dressing, pitchers, utensils, and even metal straws.
Plus, it's not that hard to just do your dishes. After a nice healthy meal of fruits and veggies, these scraps usually go into the trash, but they're still very much usable.
You can compost them. All you need to do to compost is place these scraps in an old bin with some holes in it. Cover it with soil and let it decompose. After that, you'll be left with an organic fertilizer that can replace that toxic synthetic stuff that's polluting our environment. It may not seem like you're doing a lot to help the environment, but if we all do these things, we will see improvements. And I know it can be hard to change old habits, but we have to start somewhere. Besides, if we keep this up, we might not be able to go to the beaches, swim in lakes, enjoy nature, drink clean water, or breathe fresh air. So make sure that you do your part to help save the world. The Sheriff of Polk County, Grady Judd, has been serving this community since the day my dad was born. And he's been serving as sheriff since the day I was born. Around here, he's almost like a celebrity. But when you think of Grady Judd, all that really comes to mind is the badge and the uniform. So what's he really like? Well, I'm Izzy with BDTV, and today I'm lucky enough to get to know our sheriff a little bit better and see what he does on his day off. So come on, let's go see. The sheriff likes to start his day off by taking out his pontoon on the beautiful lakes of Polk County. These lakes are so beautiful that they bring out his inner photographer. When the hat gets flipped backwards, you know the pictures are going to turn out good. After watching the sheriff, I decided it was my turn to have some time with the camera. After a morning out on the boat, the sheriff likes to get back on dry land and do some off-roading in his Jeep. After I got done jeeping with Judd, it was time to say goodbye. After all, he does have work in the morning. Wow, I was not expecting our sheriff to be that funny, friendly, and charismatic. But I guess that's why he's been our sheriff for 16 years. I'm honored to have gotten to know Grady Judd a little bit better today. Polk County is truly a safer place with Grady Judd as our sheriff.
What are you listening to in here? Bon Jovi. It's the one I used to listen to.
Okay, whatever. It's trash. I'm going to bed. Crazy dream. But honestly, the music wasn't that bad. I should probably go apologize to my parents now. I'm Izzy with BDTV. Make sure you keep an open mind.